know them. You probably know them. If you know them, you probably love them. You're about to be very entertained. Please give it up for Michael Rosenbaum. That was really sexy in that movie, wasn't it? You know some Doors?
Sure.
Just start going.
Wow.
Are you missing
it?
I don't know.
All right,
we're going to
let you guys have your
pants.
Yeah.
We're in a rush.
Poor time. We'll have
a group.
And we got to wait for people to
leave.
This is great. Where are you guys going? I would say no.
Thank you.
Aren't they awesome?
All right, now our turn to pull up.
These guys, they're really good. Need a guitar in my hand? I don't know. It's early. Why are we first up? I guess we weren't first up, were we? The ladies were first up. And ladies take longer to get ready, don't they? Except for Tom here.
Well, sorry, this panel probably won't be as entertaining as theirs. You guys sound like you're having fun.
No, we'll have fun. We're gonna have fun. Thanks for coming out. We're really excited to be here in Atlanta with you guys. And, you know, I mean, we're not supernatural. Well, I guess you're kind of supernatural. You're new supernatural.
Yeah, new supernatural.
Supernatural. Yeah. And Jensen and I were shirtless in Smallville, so that was cool.
I still have that poster.
Do you? They made a poster?
On the ceiling.
Perfect. I have that. I have Mrs. Garrett from
Facts of Life.
Is that wrong? It's probably wrong. I like Mrs. Garrett. But thank you for having us. I mean, I know this is a supernatural con, and I'm really excited that Jared Jensen and everybody welcomes us to come to this. We were like, they don't want to see us. They're here for supernatural.
And I love you!
I love you too!
That's your group right there. That's your stage.
Yeah.
That's your stage.
Signing 5 autographs. You remember Rocky when they go, I love you, Rocky. Yeah, I love you too. I love that moment. Anyway, random thing. So.
Should we get to some questions?
We can get to anything you want. Do people have questions? Yes, let's do it.
All right. Hi, I'm Susan. I'll do a little plug for all y'all and say that I went to Smallville Nights on their first time that they came to Vegas, and it was amazing. I highly recommend you come.
Thank you, Susan.
It was a lot of fun. Thank you.
Thank you.
I actually haven't watched all of Smallville.
How dare you?
But I started, and I noticed that in the first couple of seasons, you drive some pretty amazing cars. Did you actually get to drive around in those for a while? Because I'm a bit of a car nut, and I love those cars.
Yeah, I did, you know. They'd say you're going to drive a Lamborghini today or a Ferrari, and I was like, yeah! And they're like, dude, seriously, this is an expensive car. We don't want you messing around. I'm like, no. And then, you know, you'd see me just take off. And I'd be gone for like 5 minutes and just enjoying the ride, and they'd get pissed at me. But yeah, I had fun doing that.
There'd always be one guy on set, and his job was to look after the car.
Yeah.
Insurance purposes, all these other things. And he'd be like, I'm like this funny guy, he's my buddy. Yeah, I'm here taking a look at the car. I'm like, action! He's watching the scene, yeah, the car looks great. And Michael would peel out and he'd go, car! And Michael would be like, I'm just kidding, throwing the keys, and the guy would be like shaking.
Yeah, and I always try to get a deal. I'm like, hey, you know, Lex Luthor drives a Ferrari, then you can hook me up. No. The only thing they hooked me up with on Smallville, I'm going to be honest with you, is Mach 3 razor blades. They sent me a case of razor blades. I didn't know whether to shave my head or... No, I'm kidding. That was dark.
So what do you drive now?
Actually, I just got an electric truck, a Rivian. I waited 2.5 years for it, and it's awesome. I love it. It's great. And it's good for the environment.
Yeah, you can't charge it when your power goes out.
That's true. My power went out for 3 days. I was freezing with my dog. It was 42 degrees in my house. And I couldn't charge my car, so I couldn't leave. I couldn't do anything. Idiot!
I used to live in Bloomington, Illinois, where the Rivian Auto plant is, and I've actually taken a tour of the plant.
Really?
It's really cool, yeah.
That's
cool.
I've
been starting to build them, yeah.
Well, maybe I'll try to do that once.
It's really cool. You should do it.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thanks. Also, Smallville Nights is tonight. We're doing it before the concert, and if you haven't come, I promise you, we have yet to have anyone who hasn't had a blast. Everyone reads, and we read scenes. I wear a ball cap. It's just a crazy, fun, intimate show. If you haven't gotten a chance, I promise you it's going to be a highlight of your weekend. I promise you. If not, I'll do whatever.
What's your secret?
Yeah, play my guitar. What's my secret? Oh, I can't tell that joke, can I?
No.
Yes.
All right, let's do it. Next question.
Maybe on Smuggle Nights.
Maybe. Hey, there's a guitar.
All right,
next question, here we go.
I'm fine.
My name is Allie.
Who are you texting? That's not texting up there. I thought they said I want to be kissed. Are you bragging to your mom? I love you. You're a noble light. You have perfect skin. Supple, soft. The clothes. You weren't texting. You were stopping your phone from coming on what?
Every time.
You lift it. Oh, that's a weird thing then. All right, what's your question, lady?
All right, we're going, we gotta go.
Just turn it off.
Yes.
I'm silly, but I'm watching your panels from like last month. I was curious about the song like the Fly Like a Bird one.
Fly Like a Bird. That one?
Sorry.
I think he made it up.
That the song? Fly Like a Bird? Are you sure it was that song?
Isn't that Ariana Grande your favorite?
Or was it, I can't stand to fly.
That song.
I'm not that naive. Men want men to fly. It's been a I'm only a man in a silly red suit.
Thanks, Allie.
Your face is cute. And it's not easy to be me. That's a 5 for 5 song. It didn't make the cut, but it was either going to be that song for the Smallville intro or Somebody Save Me. He's like, what the hell is that? Guy grabs my head at 10 in the morning.
The one time you sit in the front row, okay?
Can you stand up, please, young lady? Can you stand up? Oh, you can't. You have a hurt foot. Oh, how do you say diarrhea in sign language? Diarrhea, diarrhea, diarrhea. How do you say explosive diarrhea? Okay, that might be me later. I had 2 Starbucks. TMI, dude. Just TMI, dude. Yeah, you wish you had diarrhea. All right, go ahead.
What? Okay. What? Okay, sorry.
It's okay. It's normal. It's natural. People have it. People do it. Genetic? What is it? Genetic? Runs in my genes. It's genetic, right? That was good! I liked it. Go ahead.
So, funny story. My parents loved Smallville so much, they named me after Lana Lane. So, my name is Lana.
Lana! Did you like kissing Lex? I'm kidding. The real Lana kissed Lex. Go ahead. What's your question? Just one of you, damn it. Live with it.
If you had a theme song for your life, what would it be?
all by myself. Don't wanna be all by myself anymore. Yes! That's it! I'm still single, I'm 50 years old, it's sad. I've been in relationships, don't look at me like I haven't been. I mean, I do go on dates. It just hasn't worked out. I'm balding, huh? What?
You pull it off well.
Ooh, thank you. That's what she said. Who's next? Who's next? Go ahead, talk louder, you got it.
Sorry. So, Michael, you remember the episode where they split you with the black kryptonite?
Yep.
And you came out, and you were at the bar, and you said, I am the villain of the story.
Yeah, I said, you were right about me all along, Mr. Kent. I am the villain of the story! Yeah, that was one of my favorites.
That was seriously scary, and I wish that you could have done more of that.
I'm gonna give you James Gunn's telephone number. And he had just texted that.
So,
thank you.
When is the cartoon?
We're still working on it. You know, there's a new regime over there, and they're doing a lot of things differently. So we're gonna see. A lot of change is going on. We want to do it. Maybe we should just do it. We should get an animator to just do it. And then just, you know, and then get sued. What if we do parodies? Like, I'll be Rex and you'll be Mark.
Let's sell for crypto. That way no one will know it's us.
Yeah. Bitcoin is what you're allergic to. Allergic. Allergic. Like, he's allergic to kryptonite. Next question.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, Brittany, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Fair to horseshit. Thanks for asking.
I'm just wondering what villain or superhero you guys would play other than Clark Kent and Lex Luthor.
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know what you said. What villain or superhero would you play?
I would say Batman.
That's right.
Can't say the Penguin again.
That's good, Batman. You know, I auditioned for the Bruce Timm. They're doing an animated series for HBO Max. It's not going now, I don't think. But I remember I auditioned for, and I went back a couple times, and I ended up being one of the finals for, listen to me, I'm Batman. And I did this whole thing, and it was good. But my Bruce Wayne, I guess, wasn't good.
So Batman's Clint Eastwood now.
Oh, yeah. Well, punk, what are you gonna do? I'm Batman, damn it. Do I have one bullet in this gun or not? Next question.
Hi, Michael. I just was wondering, with your podcast, is there anyone that you have interviewed that you'd like to interview in the future?
Well, I just texted Tom the other day, and I said, you gotta come back on the podcast. Because he's a regular, like, he's like once a year. I have Tom since the beginning. You always want to see him on the podcast. But like,
I want to do it when I'm in LA at your house. That's
true. You know, I've had great guests. Like, I just had J.K. Simmons and Bob Odenkirk and Judd Apatow and Rachel Lee Cook was just on and Kristen Ritter's coming on and
Rachel's like the cool. Isn't she so cool?
She's so cool. Kumail Nanjiani's coming back on. Just so many great people. But the important thing about the podcast, as you know, is we open up about real stuff, about mental health and anxiety and life, and it's not just two celebrities going, hey, so were you at that party?
It's like two guys on a stage doing a panel.
Yeah, exactly. But, you know, I'd love to have Gary Oldman. I still, my list is high. I like to have Keanu Reeves. So it's not impossible. I just have to keep working at it. Because Keanu I worked with, so one of my best friends is really close friends with him, but he's just, the guy's so busy, and he's such a nice guy. I hope he'll do it. And Gary Oldman, I bought pizza for once. We have the same hairstylist.
He owes you.
He owes me.
What kind of pizza did you
use? It was pepperoni pizza. See, I brought it. I knew he was going to be there before I got my haircut. So I got a big pizza, and I went in there and go, oh, hey! And my guy's like, oh, you met Gary before? I go, Gary, yeah, you signed my Dracula poster. You put, I have crossed oceans of time to find you. He goes, oh, yeah. I don't fucking remember that one. And then I said, yeah, hey, we brought some pizza. He goes, no, take it. I can't eat all this. He goes, you don't mind. I go, no. And he had some pizza with me, and we sat there and talked. I should have asked him right then. But it wasn't the moment. All right, next question.
My name's Aiden, and my question's for Tom. How much did you bench season 1 compared to season 10?
Well, I don't think I was benching in season 10 at all, so... I lifted a lot of weights when I was in high school. But after that, I kind of got away from it. I think for Smallville, I was just a lot younger. And season 2 to like 5 or 6, I got into... kind of like recreational kickboxing, working out, stunt stuff for the show. And then, yeah, toward the end there wasn't much gym time.
Your body was so good.
It was.
I just thought, we're doing the Rewatch podcast, Talkville. And it's awesome. If you haven't seen that one, it's like, we're forced to watch every episode and then critique it. And they usually say, Rosenbaum shit on the show. I'm just like being honest about it.
Well, one of the funny things, if we're talking about their clothes up, Michael's, his numerous sex scenes on Smallville were all cut out of the show. And they would tell him like 2 weeks before, you're going to have a shirtless scene, so he would like try to do it for him.
I would pump so much iron. I would do so many push-ups to look as good as I could, and then they would cut it. And it got, I had a complex. I was like, why are you cutting my sex scenes? Like, you don't cut Tom's, are they just...
If you're gonna cut them, I don't want to do them. It's really...
Yeah. Well, no, I still want to do them. Yeah.
And action.
All right, next question.
What you doing later?
Next question. Next question.
Hey, my name's Jody.
Jody, how are you?
This is literally the best Ali Bate present I've ever gotten from my mom.
Yeah! Give it up! Happy birthday, Mom!
I'm not a mom, no, I'm a cat mom.
It's her birthday.
Oh, it's your birthday? Oh, you're a cat mom.
Yeah, I'm a cat mom.
I love that.
Yeah.
I've learned to love cats over the years. Yeah. I really have. I'm allergic to them though, so just keep away.
Okay, I've got a question I've been dying to ask you guys for years. And I actually like met you guys in Metropolis, Illinois when I was around 15 or 16. Yeah. But I didn't know how to ask you guys back then.
Well, ask us now.
Yeah. I was wondering like how Lex and Clark's dynamic on the show would have changed had Clark been able, to tell Lex his secret.
Yes, I know what you're saying. Good question. If Clark would have told Lex his secret early on, Lex might not have gone bad. Maybe Lex would be good. Maybe they would have done really good together. But he was a liar! He lied to me! Huh? You blame Lionel?
Yeah,
I mean, he wasn't good, so I threw him out of a window. That's what happens. But I think the good thing is that you see, I think that it's never been done, I don't think, but the fact that you got to see Lex good, Lex trying to be good, and of course he has flaws along the way, but you see that he's really trying to be, he's not trying not to be his father. And so he looks at the Kent family and he adores them and he wishes that he had that family and he tries to embrace them and wants Mr. Kent to embrace, and they never do. And
oh, you're still
I'm dreaming. Next question. Are you looking at your phone for the question, ma'am? Where's Nancy, by the way? Nancy? She's not here, she can show up? Oh, great, awesome.
Hi, Michael. Hi, Tom. How are you?
Pretty good. Thank you for asking.
Just wanted to welcome you guys to the family. You guys are awesome.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
So, Michael, I just wanted to just piggyback to just let you know that the Inside of You podcast, I got into it during the pandemic, and it was really great, and it got me through some times, and so it's great that you're so open with the guests, and you guys talk about mental health and everything, so thank you so much for that.
That means a lot. You know, it's funny because I never thought this podcast would do that. I didn't know what the podcast was originally, and then I started opening up and talking about my dysfunction and my family and my anxiety and my life, and that brought other actors to talk about and other people. And you laughing? My shirt?
Oh, yeah, my shirt.
What does my shirt say?
You don't laugh at people
my
when they talk about
me. My favorite childhood memory is my back not hurting.
Yes. And, yeah, right? Right? It's true. But thank you very much. Oh, guy
yeah.
Over here.
Yeah. And yeah, so thank you again for that.
Thank you. It means a lot to me. Thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, thank you. And for Tom, I just wanted to know how it was filming and being around Brendan Fraser.
Ooh. Oh, that was great. He's a very kind, wonderful person. His character wasn't really supposed to be likable. That was something he brought to it, which made my job harder, because I wasn't supposed to like his character at the beginning. But one of the kindest, sweetest people. I'm so happy that he's, you know, getting all this attention right now, and I know he's really enjoying it.
Would he still text you back, even though he's nominated for an Oscar?
Yeah, he'll text me back.
Do it now!
Text Brendan Fraser.
I'll just FaceTime him.
That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, you work with
Brendan Fraser, man. That's awesome. You know what? He worked with you.
Well,
because you're my Superman. It's true. Next question.
Hey. So. Oh, sorry. So my name is Rose. First of all, tell my love to you on Lucifer show.
Thank you.
And I have a question. If you guys were on the show Supernatural, what character you guys would like to play?
Well, it'd be funny if we played Jensen and Jared together. That would be funny. I don't know, it'd probably be fun to be like a demon or something, or, you know. As long as I didn't have to do what Mark Shepard does, and that's like speak for 5 pages so nobody else has to. And he's really good at it, I love him, but that's not my cup of tea.
Up, up, and away, away from me, but it's alright. All sleep sound tonight. I'm not crazy or anything. Next question.
Right,
who's coming to Smallville Nights now? Yeah! Alright.
For Tom. What's up, Tom? First off, 20 minutes, final show of Smallville. You finally donned the suit. Could you, and if you would you ever do a full season of you in the suit?
Smallville?
Ow.
Dude, that'd be funny. I tell you what would be funny. So the show ends, right? Clark leaps, he takes off. And then you see him running around Smallville. He runs into the talent, makes up some coffee to help Lana. She's like, Clark? And then he runs outside and there's Lex getting to his porch. Clark. Like he knew it the whole time. It could be interesting. But he just runs around everybody the whole time, yeah.
You know what I thought would be cool? Is a show.
I guess Lana's already gone, so.
It's a parody about Clark and Lex. But Clark doesn't have any powers, and Lex isn't smart anymore. He lost his brilliance in this other universe, what do they call those? Multiverse. I'm so confused by all that shit. Well, it's funny because we're trying to do a show about sort of that, where we're two guys who are doing a show. It got canceled years ago. We lived together in this dilapidated house in like Burbank, California, and we're just trying to get back on our feet. And it's funny, so you know, we might do crowdfunding or something to make if you want to make this thing. But I think that would be kind of cool to see, like, well, you figured out Lex, you're the one that's brilliant. Don't say that, you know I'm not that smart anymore. Why don't you just break open the door? I wish I could. Anyway.
And also, one other. You just mentioned working with Brendan Fraser. There's talk about him doing Mummy 4. Would you be up for that as maybe the mummy against his Brendan Fraser?
I'm not a mummy.
Yeah. How long does it take to be wrapped like a mummy, though?
No, I get CG. They'll put dots on your head like they did for me for Guardians 3.
Yeah.
It's easy.
That'd be fun. It'd be great.
Thank you.
It's funny because those dots they put on my head, I watch some of the stuff in Guardians that's coming out, and my character Mark next to it actually this time looks like me. They put these, they made the crystals look like me. It's pretty dope. It's like, hey, look at that, right?
It's me.
Why couldn't it just be me? All right, next question.
Hi, I'm Michelle. It's nice to meet you guys. I started watching Smallville when I was 10 years old, so like the first year it started.
So you're 22?
Huh?
Are you 22?
No, I was 10.
Oh, how old are you now?
22.
Oh, now I'm 31.
See, I'm good at mine.
I'm old. Very old.
My 6-year-old son has walked in on me watching it a few times, and he loves the song when by AFI, when the building explodes, 33.1.
Oh, yeah.
He loves that scene, so I'll play just that scene for him. So I was wondering what your favorite scene to shoot was.
Tom?
We just watched an episode where Lex finds out there's bugs in, listening devices in his office, and he runs to his office breaking everything, and we had a good time with the podcast because just an episode or two before, it's an issue, it's an episode about Lex dealing with his anger issues, where he meets a doctor who says, you know, she has anger issues too, because he took a 9-iron to a meter maid's car. And here we are, two episodes later, he's destroying his entire office and they're playing the worst music ever, which is why it comes to mind because he really enjoyed filming that scene.
Remember I'm walking the hallway?
Kiss my eyes and lay me to sleep.
Which sounded kind of silly until we actually thought about it. And someone asked us, in that scene I was talking about when Michael's destroying the office and there's this really crazy hardcore music playing. And someone asked, was there music playing on set during that day? And we were like, that's actually a good question. Because...
yeah, it would have gave me some energy.
Yeah, you would have done the little flip
twirl thing.
By the way, what's this song?
Good, a lot of times they don't know what the music is, but they're going to put on a set.
My new album!
Friday night, you lost your self-control.
You guys will like this new song.
Saturday,
whether you like it or not, you can hear it.
Pretty cool though, right?
Please.
That's the only way you're gonna get them to listen to it.
The only way.
Otherwise, they go, go listen to my album. Oh yeah, sure. How are ya? But if you just play it, they're forced to listen to it. They may not like it, but they're forced to listen to it. Next question, sir.
So up until high school, my name's Steven, by the way.
Hi, Steven.
Up until high school, I absolutely hated the Superman character.
Awesome.
In general.
But too.
You guys are the reason I now, you guys are my favorite version of Superman and Lex, respectively. So I was...
Thank you.
I was just curious as to who would you say are your top three favorite Supermans or Lexes?
Go ahead.
Three? How many are there?
Yeah, I don't know.
Only like three of each. I mean, for me, Chris Owens is the one that is a Superman.
Yeah.
And
Chris is the
reading.
you know, second to Michael, Gene Hackman was fun to watch and creepy as a kid watching, you know, Superman stuff. So yeah, good Superman for me. I know Michael's a big General Zod fan.
What?
Excuse me, sorry.
How could you do that? How could you burp in front of all these people? Was it you? Was your sister your mom?
Whatever. I love how she defends herself.
You know what's... Look, I love Gene Hackman. He signed my Superman poster. He's my Lex Luthor. So I'm not going to get into that. I mean, like, here's what I don't understand. Some people say, you know, they categorize every Lex, whether it's animated or... I think that should be different. Live action's a completely different thing. I mean, you're using your body and everything, memorizing lines and... The animation is awesome, but that should be categorized. And my favorite Lex animated is Clancy Brown, without a doubt. He's amazing, awesome. Superman, I mean, honestly, besides Christopher Reeve, this is the guy, period. There's nobody, that's it. I mean, that's it. Like, you watched him grow for 10 years. You watched him become ultimately who he is. And everybody can, you know, they're Superman now, and they just, you know, whatever. He's the guy. That's it.
Thank you.
Yeah, he is. And by the way, he's so charming. And like, if you watch his character, he had that naivete that, like, in the beginning, he was Superman. He was Clark because he hadn't really acted a lot. He hadn't really done much. So you're watching what Clark Kent would really be. He was like one of us. He was just a dude. He was just a guy trying to figure out his lines, figuring out the world, figuring out being like a star, figuring out that he's Superman. All of it was like really happening in real time.
Yeah.
Next question.
Hi there.
Hi there.
I've never seen Smallville ever. Sorry.
Get out!
I'm really happy that I saw you here because I started listening to your podcast when you were interviewing these guys.
Thank you.
I stayed because I love you.
I love you.
So one thing that you do a lot is you just like bust into Chris Farley, and it's like the best freaking Chris Farley I've ever heard, besides Chris Farley.
I love Chris. I had a dream about Chris Farley last night, I swear to God. Swear to God in my life.
Lovely. You have to do it for whichever one of the ladies said that they love Chris Farley so much. I think it might have been Brianna. But anyways, will you do it?
Do you guys know Chris Farley?
Yes!
My voice is already gone. You should do it.
Yes!
Do it!
Well, I'll just tell you this story. So real quick, I was doing a show called The Tom Show. It was with Tom Arnold in 1998, and nobody saw the show. It was ranked 132 out of 131 shows. Worst show on television. It was me, Ed McMahon, Tom Arnold. I was just getting started. And the Farley brothers, not Chris, but Kevin and Johnny, they were recurring characters on the show. And we became good friends. They moved in. They lived above me. We partied together. We had fun. And one Friday night, we're recording the show live in front of a studio audience. You know the story, right?
Yeah, it's a good one.
And I'm delivering my lines, and the audience is really laughing, and it's not really funny, what I'm saying. So I'm like, something's odd. And I turn, and I see Chris Farley walking into the studio in a suit, going, looking at the guy, going, "Don't worry, I'll be right back." All right. You know, all that stuff, and I'm like, heart starts pounding. This is my idol, it's Chris Farley, I gotta do something, I gotta say something that he'll remember me for the rest of my life, I gotta make an impact. And finally I just stopped in front of the whole studio audience and the crew and the cast, and I went, "Hey, look everybody! It's the big, fat, successful guy, taking all the attention away from the skinny bum! Start trying to make it!" And Farley looks over and goes, "All right, guess that's your theory." And he storms over and goes, "That's it!" Grabs me over his shoulder, smacks me on my ass, runs through the audience. Everybody in the audience is smacking me on my ass. And I'll post something, but I have a picture of me and him from that night. And we went out, and we hung out, and he was so cool, and I just said, "Hey, man, I'm not just saying this, like, there's nobody funnier, nobody will ever be funnier than you, you just have a way of making everyone laugh all the time." He goes, well, you're not laughing. And he would just like, he just looked at me and go, and kind of grabbed me, and he rode around on the, what are those, the golf carts up near the Universal, where the Psycho House is in Universal, had some beers, and like, I'm like, this is legendary. And then I hung out with him for a couple of months, and then, you know, obviously what happened, happened. It was, but I was with his brother when he passed away, when Chris passed away. Kevin was on set. It was tragic. He, I saw him running off set. I go, Kevin, are you all right? And he just was in tears. He could barely get out of it. He goes, I lost my brother. And it was just heart-wrenching. I mean, gut-wrenching. It was just, it was the worst. So, but anyway, he's always been a hero. I love Chris Farley, and my zipper's been down the entire time. Not even kidding. Did you guys notice that?
Oh, yeah.
Why do you say something? If anybody that pulls my zipper down and puts it up, I will hate you. Don't do it. What's wrong with me? That's why you were taking a picture, you pervert. You can't do that this day and age. Man, zipper, and I do not have a license to sell hot dogs, man. You couldn't get the phone off. I gotta get a safety pin or something.
Or what do they call them, a bobby pin?
What do they call them, a bobby pin?
A bobby pin goes in your hair. Safety pin holds it up.
Oh, thank you. Next question.
Hi, I'm Myra. Nice to meet you guys.
Ira?
Myra.
Myra. Ew, Myra.
Was my repeat movie in like second grade. I watched it multiple times a week. My parents hated the movie. Then we started watching Smallville, Lucifer, The Winchester. So I've like been watching you a while.
You've been able to watch something every year.
I know.
What a good timing you had.
So I know what my experience has been like watching you all those years. What's your experience watching fans grow along with all your roles, and then how did it feel like the first time you started getting dad roles instead of teenage heartthrob roles?
Well, we are at the end of the show tonight, and we hope you all have a good time.
At least I can play a dad.
Yeah, I can't play a dad yet. They don't believe it.
Well, let's start unpacking that question. I'm happy to be working. I will tell you, it's been, you know, we do this podcast, Talkville, and it's enough time has passed now that we can watch it and have fun watching it. And some of our guests that we have come on haven't watched Smallville for many years or never did, so they'll watch an episode and they'll be like we just had Eric Johnson, he was like, how young we were. He obviously hadn't looked at the show in like 15 years. We're in season two of it, so we're used to seeing these younger people that we claim are used to be us. But it's a lot of fun now to be able to watch it and sort of appreciate it and enjoy it. And then the dad stuff, yeah, I don't know how that happened. It just like, all of a sudden, you know, on Winchester's, I mean, she could be my daughter in a way. I'm that much older, but I would have been very young when I had it. But yeah, we just don't really get into it so much. But yeah. It's fun. And it was great being Charlie Baker because I didn't really have to deal with the kids at all. Everybody left me alone because I was shooting that in between seasons of Smallville where I had anywhere from 4 to 5 people with me at all any given time. I wasn't allowed to go anywhere. I had to tell people that I was going to the bathroom. And somebody would follow you to make sure you came out. And then I got to Cheaper by the Dozen and there were so many kids that nobody, they would just like run past my trailer and they'd be like, Tom, I'm ready, Martin! And then they'd be like, I was not working. Oh, thank you. I didn't have my voice. So it was really great. They just made great it. I just find my way to set, do my thing, walk away. Nobody paid attention to me. I loved it.
Awesome.
Yeah.
You know what's funny is I know it was your question, but I was thinking about that, how I would have answered that question. No, but like honestly, like, you know, you're older and you know, I gotta admit, when I was growing up, I didn't think I'd amount to anything. Like you know me, I've talked about it, but like
there's still time.
Yeah. But you know, I thought I'd work at a grocery store. I'd work, you know, a go-kart track, or maybe be a DJ in town. I didn't know. I mean, so like, boy, I knocked it out of the park. Like, I wasn't expecting that. So really, to me, this is just all gravy. It's like, wow, just enjoy it. Like, who cares? It's like, what else do you need to do, really?
I'm surprised you haven't bought an arcade or...
I have, like, 4 arcade games in my house.
Yeah, but, or like a, I'm surprised you don't own a go-kart track.
I will. That is actually my goal. What keeps me going is I want to have an estate. Now, I know it sounds like, you know, pretentious or whatever. I'm not talking about an estate in Hollywood. I'm talking about where I grew up in Indiana. So you can get an estate for like $200,000. Okay? And I'm talking about land and creating a go-kart track and softball and like all this stuff and like just having this fun house that my friends can come to and just like a commune. No, not like Michael Jackson. Wrong kind of party. Different party. No, I mean, he had merry-go-round, but that was rich money. All right, next question.
Do you have a question, or are you asking her?
Okay, you gotta just go with your own.
It's
not
time. Okay, my name's Haley. I'm really excited you guys are here. I've been binge watching it again, Smallville, since I found out last week. But my question is, on Smallville, was it on purpose or coincidence? There's so many parallels to the Bible.
Oh, what's the Bible?
I don't know.
Sorry. That joke. There's like the Christ-like figure, especially the cornfield, and you know the savior aspect and the Lucifer aspect.
Well, what about the name? Kal-El. Anytime there's L, it means God. You know, like.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like Joel.
Kal-El. Well, I'm sure there's a parallel. That's why the show is for everybody.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. Like
that's cool.
I didn't know that.
You didn't realize?
No.
Well, I guess we'll have to go back and watch it all again. Thank you. Next question.
Hey guys. So Smallville wasn't really something that I watched a whole lot.
All right.
But yeah. But Justice League Unlimited was one of my absolute childhood TV shows while it was. And I was just wondering, since you work with Clancy Brown and since you know George Newbern and all of them, did you guys have any influences from any of those with your characters?
No, I think, that was a really special show, and it should have lasted more than the seasons it did. People, I really loved it. The animation was awesome, the music, the characters. I loved playing The Flash. But I think we just brought our own thing to it, and that's what they liked when we auditioned. I had no idea. Like, I told Tom, I'm a horror movie guy. I watch documentaries and horror movies, and most horror movies suck these days. Did you see Nope?
Nope.
Anyway, so I'd say no. I'd say we just kind of, you know, brought it, and they liked what we were doing. So yeah, thank you. Start watching Smallville.
So I'm more familiar.
It's on Hulu. It's free, for God's sake.
I'm more familiar with you guys from Supernatural RFK fanfic, and Tom, I am really glad I sat in this panel this morning so I could see you. Because those stories are gonna be a whole lot better. Thanks.
Well, well, well. You sassy pants over there. She's,
I didn't hear a question.
Yeah, it was more of a statement. Yeah, she's a woman on her mission. That's what she is. Next question.
Hi, my name is Sydney. I'm over here.
Awesome.
I just want to say I've been a fan for years. The only reason I am here is for you two.
Hear that, Jared? Jensen?
I have all of the Smallville DVDs on display in my house.
Beautiful.
And my question is, besides Smallville, which one of your projects was your favorite?
You know, I like...
Perfect timing!
Yeah! I honestly loved directing my own movie called Back in the Day. It was like a raunchy comedy, like Sandler-esque kind of movie. I made it for no money in Indiana. I loved it. I loved doing Sorority Boys. It was a freaking blast. And I like Pool Hall Junkies, which he loved.
That's one of my favorites of Michael's. I can still watch that. So, for me, I did a movie about the people behind, who had to deal with the JFK assassination called Parkland, which is really good. My little buddy.
I love that!
Yeah. A lot of people maybe not know about that one, but I think it's worth watching. And then being able to yell at Kevin Costner on draft day was a lot of fun.
Oh yeah. And now it's time for Round Sway and Jason Mayers.
So right now, we have a